America. Arrived at Tours at an age of 74, she was promoted to glory and interred in Guntur. Her main concern was medical aid to women. Gynecology and obstetrics were her specialities. She was concerned with physical and spiritual welfare of the people who sought her help. Video recording, Neptune Studio. Editor and narrator, Reverend D.V. Daniel. Sound recording, Swathavani. Produced by Dr. Sarala Elisha and directed by John S. Rao. Dr. John Christian Frederick Hayer, familiarly known as Father Hayer, is the founder of the Andhra Evangelical Lutheran Church, which runs the hospital. Father Hayer himself was an MD. The AELC manages many educational institutions like the Andhra Lutheran College of Education, Andhra Christian College, and several high schools for boys and girls. Right in Guntur, the church runs Salgars High School, known for its educational standards. This is the main entrance gate of the hospital. The hospital was dedicated on June 2nd of the year 1897 and was officially opened with two patients in December 1898. On annual average, 50,000 people are treated as outpatients and 5,000 as inpatients. Average stay of inpatients is 10 days. This is the School of Nursing attached to the hospital. In this building also is located the home for nurses. Students from all parts of India, especially South India, come here for training. This is called Zimmerman Memorial Chapel. Every morning and evening, worship services are quiz chapel. Besides the students and staff, the relatives of the inpatients also attend the service. This is not only a place of congregational worship, but also an abode for personal meditation and contemplation. Because many non-Telugu students are in the community, services in English are also conducted. This is Reverend P. Adams, the chaplain of the hospital. Every day, patients are brought to the hospital, mostly in rickshaws. When a patient arrives, ward boys and nurses receive him or her, and then he is wheeled into the admission room, where the doctor on duty conducts preliminary investigations. Then, upon the doctor's advice, the patient is taken to the respective ward. This is Dr. Sukumar examining the patient. Dr. Sarala Elisha, MBBS DGO, is the medical superintendent of the hospital. She has been serving here for the last 30 years as medical officer and for 16 years as a medical superintendent. This is the old outpatient department building where Dr. Kugler originally started her medical ministry. And this building is the new outpatient department. Kugler Hospital has several departments. This is ophthalmology department, and it is headed by Dr. Dayak. On average, 10,000 eye patients are treated here, and 1,000 operations are conducted at eye camps. Patients are waiting consultation with the doctor. This is eye operation room. Dr. Dayaka and Dr. Prasadrao are operating on a patient using cryo unit. This is Dr. Kam Prasad, Assistant Professor of Surgery, Medical College, Guntur. He is the General Surgeon of Kugler Hospital today. On average, over 1,000 general surgical operations are conducted per year in this hospital. This is Dr. R. Vama Devi, dental surgeon of the hospital, extracting to the antenatal ward of the hospital. This was a gift from the Lutheran World Federation. This is Dr. Amrita. Dr. Hilda Sanjeev Rao, in charge of this department. Of labor rooms and operation theaters in Guntur hospitals is a must. This is Mrs. Augustine. Guntur Hospital is now going to introduce his staff to us.
It is known for its charity from the beginning. Annually, free services and charity shown to patients amount to over 200,000 rupees. We have a staff of about 6 members here, and charity shown to patients amount to over 200,000 rupees. Subsidy given by the Lutheran Church in Ars, she has been the registrar of the hospital, and she now takes care of the bills and also receiving part of the cash. Here is Salome. He is our typist town clerk. He has been helping in the filing and correspondence of the hospital office. Vardhan is a new appointee. He is typist and also he takes care of the records room.
K.J. Krishnamurthy, physician in charge of the hospital. We are now in the male medical ward. Assisting Dr. Krishnamurthy are Dr. Sukumar, Dr. Parimala, and Mrs. Devanamma, staff nurse in charge of the ward. They are examining a patient, Reverend P.J. Simon. This is Mrs. K. Vijayannamma. She is a trained nurse and a pharmacist as well. She is head of the Department of Pharmacy. She has been serving in this hospital for the past 30 years. This is Mr. Anand Rao, another pharmacist in the same department. Many volunteers from different countries come to Kugler Hospital to serve here. This is Jane, a volunteer from United Kingdom. This is the children's ward of the hospital. Here is Dr. Varaprasad, physician in charge of the ward. Assisting him is Mrs. Amelia, one of the senior staff nurses. Dr. Varaprasad is examining a child patient. Clinical pathology. Mr. One of the important departments of the hospital. Mr. Augustine, who is the head of this department, is assisted by Mr. Sukunda Rao, Mrs. Jesse Manohar, and Jay Raj. This machinery was a gift from Oxfam, England, and was dedicated by Dr. Marshall, the former president of the Lutheran Church in America. This is Mr. Sudhiraj, who the prosthetic and orthotic center is one of the recent additions to the hospital. This is the first of its kind in this area. Manufactured here are Belloni prostheses, fixed angle brace, patellar tendon brace, calipers, spinal brace, special microcellular rubber chapels meant for patients. Another recent addition to the hospital. This is being helped by the volunteers from Holland. This is Mika, a volunteer from Holland. Mrs. Nujihan, one of the senior staff nurses, is in charge here. All sterile supplies to various departments of the hospital go from here. The supplies include nursing, medical, surgical, and housekeeping material. This is Lalitha standing at the storeroom. Dr. Daniel Sudhakar, Dr. Paul Wilson, and Dr. Varaprasad Rao are conferring between themselves on a particular case which needs their attention. Now, something about the Community Health Department. Dr. Kugler had always evinced a keen concern for the total care of her patients. She visited them even in their homes. Kugler Hospital began its formal community health department in the year 1962. Follow-up care is constantly offered by this department. The old dispensary building where Dr. Kugler started the first outpatient work is now being used for the community health department. This vehicle, a gift from Save the Children Fund England, is being used by the Community Health Department for its outreach work. In the year 1977, Guntur was hit by a severe cyclone, rendering many people homeless. The government resettled those families in a place, and the colony is known as Tufan Nagar, or Cyclone Colony. Tufan Nagar is a slum area where medical aid and community health education are among the needs of the inhabitants. The vehicle is moving towards the destination, the cyclone colony. Kugler Hospital's Community Health Department has adopted this slum area for intensive medical care. They pay regular visits to the area and impart to the people. Local school building for their base of operations. The team gives education on community health, and the people gather together to listen with earnestness and anxiety. The team uses charts and many other teaching aids. Lived originally when she began her work in Guntur. We are now moving on to the Raja Chennamarao Chowdhury, which was a gift to the hospital by the Raja of Elor because his wife was treated and cured through the hands of Dr. Kugler by God's mercy. As a token of his appreciation for the services of Kugler Hospital, the Raja of Elor gave these buildings as a gift to the hospital. Here, the relatives of the patients stay until the patients are discharged. The hospital charges a nominal rent. This is the building which houses the home for nurses and the school of nursing education. As the accommodation was insufficient, a new block was added to the old one. Viewed from the School of Nursing, this is the maternity ward of the hospital. The Kugler School of Nursing enters its 84th year of organized nursing education this year. Funds for this building given by Women's Missionary Society, ULCA. Miss Catherine Foss, first missionary nursing superintendent, who toiled untiringly to establish the school in the year 1899. She is ever remembered with deep gratitude. She continued her work for over 25 years in the School of Nursing. The first class began in 1899 and it was graduated in 1901. This is the recreation hall of the School of Nursing. Mrs. Shanti Devi, the director of School of Nursing and nursing superintendent of the hospital, is an old student of the School of Nursing, Kugler Hospital, Guntur. She did her master's in science in nursing at CMC Vellore.
The school is enjoying a wide reputation throughout South India for its standards of instruction and performance. The graduates of this school can be found in almost all continents of the world.
Miss Theodora Kennedoffa has served in the school and in the hospital for 33 years and remains to be the first missionary nursing superintendent with the longest years of service.
She was an efficient and dynamic nursing administrator and educator who elevated the standards of nursing education in this school and other nursing schools in South India. She served as the Secretary of Board of Nursing Education, Christian Medical Association of India, for several years.
It is through her efforts, with a foresight and vision, that the school was produced excellent graduates who today have become sisters in charge of teaching and supervision.
Here is Miss Sundarama, who did her midwifery tutor's course at Delhi. Alice Grace, who secured BSc degree in nursing at CMC Hospital, College of Nursing, Vellore.
Mrs. Grace David, sister in charge of operating room. She did her theatre technique course at Nagarkoil.
Mrs. Subina, who did diploma in teaching and supervision at College of Nursing, Vellore.
Her colleagues on important matters related to the teaching.
Mrs. Bhagyama, housekeeper.
The school is always proud of its products because results have been always almost good. It obtained 100% success this year when all its students passed in their examinations and a few passed with distinction. Learning activities of students are twofold, providing for classroom learning and clinical learning.
Here is tutor taking a class with second year students. Students enjoy participating in discussions.
Their teacher explains it with the help of teaching aids. A tug of war played by the student nurses. The school provides to its students long-lasting memories of their lives. It gives them opportunities to demonstrate their abilities and talents. This is a boat song given by the students of the School of Nursing. They have opportunities for games, sports, dancing, acting, singing, and music. This is one of the ways the leadership abilities are encouraged and developed in the School of Nursing. This is a skit. The students have adequate time, not only for learning and practicing what they learn, but also for fun and socializing. This is such a get-together. Some students, when they enter the School of Nursing, are timid and shy, but by the time they complete the training and leave, they realize that their leadership qualities are discovered and well-groomed. This is the story of Kugler House.